Patch 1.1.7 was released and there is a minor change in the strategic outpost. The developers changed the outpost cooldown from 1 minute to 30 seconds. There are also plans for outpost rework in the future, which will probably be released in Season 2. With the outpost rework, there are also plans to make amorphous materials to be obtainable in infiltration operations, which will provide more options in farming amorphous materials. With this change, this will surely affect Sharen as she's the only descendant that can successfully capture a strategic outpost because she's the only descendant with a stealth ability. To be honest with you guys, Sharen is one of my favorite descendants in the game despite having a very low damage output. The reason why I enjoy playing Sharen is because she has a melee ability and a stealth ability which I really enjoy. If we compare Sharen against Bunny and Freyna, she is at the bottom when it comes to single target damage and AoE damage. For sure, Sharen will be reworked in Season 2 because she is just underperforming, and not to mention her transcendent modules are really not that great. Not only that, Sharen also doesn't have a lot of skins if you compare it to Bunny. It is as if she is the neglected descendant in the game. I expect that the rework will make her better, and I expect that her skills are going to be fun to play with. If you guys remember, Freyna started pretty bad, and when the developers reworked some of her skills and her transcendent modules, she turned out to be an insane beast, especially in 400% invasion missions and boss fights. I just hope that when the developers rework Sharen, she will not be a mandatory descendant for the new boss fight. I really don't like the idea of having a specific descendant to make a boss fight easier, just like what they did to Gluttony. Having a Volby with a specific transcendent module made the fight so much easier. There is also a change on the ultimate module Sweeping Squad, which increases firearm attack by 10% per stack at a 100% chance every time you defeat an enemy for 5 seconds. Now, I think that the developers should reconsider the firearm attack increase, instead change it to firearm critical hit rate, because as of right now, we have so much firearm attack but not a lot of firearm critical hit rate bonus. If you use the search bar, you will notice that there are a lot of ultimate modules with firearm attack and only one firearm critical hit rate ultimate module that nobody wants to use. I don't know why, but it seems the developers are so focused on increasing the firearm attack damage on our weapons. Moving on, today is Friday and ETA 0 is here. This is the ETA 0 5th week. These are the available items in the infiltration operation rewards. So for this week, we are getting equipment slot plus 2, perforator blueprint, energy activator blueprint, peacemaker synthetic fiber blueprint, wave of light nanotube blueprint, isemo enhanced cells blueprint, clairvoyance polymer syncytium blueprint, and Sharen enhanced cells. For the paint, we are getting clear red orange, matte candlelight yellow, and sun-kissed beige. And for the hair paint, natural yellow. For the exchange supplies, these are the available items: storage slot plus 2, blue beetle blueprint, glay code, secret garden polymer syncytium blueprint, Nazestra's devotion nanotube blueprint, and restored relic nanotube blueprint. For the paint, we are getting real matte black, matte red, and shiny metal ivory. And for the hair paint, natural brown. These are all the recent updates this week, and these are all the items that you can purchase in the ETA 0. Do not forget to purchase all the items that you need, and as always, thank you for watching and have a nice day and enjoy your weekend.